Friends, in the name of Jesus Christ, we want to welcome you to the baccalaureate service for you, the class of 2021. Congratulations to one and all. Each year, I personally give thanks. I am blessed and awed by the students and the families who ask for this service, by the administrators, faculty, and staff at FHS who support and assist the planning and executing of this service, and by the ministries of the Farmington Ministerial Association who are so devoted to being part of providing this service for you. This year has been another very different year indeed. At times in the midst of it all, each of us may have even rightfully asked, so where is God in all of this? For we who believe, as we celebrate the class of 2021 and so much more, let us trust anew and continue to believe in new ways that God has gone nowhere, that God is forever now here and will always be right here where we need him most. To remind us, to center us, to reassure us, to get us started, let us proclaim. Let us begin our service by making known the one who is faithful and gracious is here. So we worship in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Hi, my name is Sarah Nordling, and I'm a faith club leader at the high school. I love finding Bible verses that remind me of the importance of living out our lives for the Lord. And one verse that has always stood out to me is John 13:7, and it says, Jesus replied, "You do not realize now what I am doing, but later you will understand." And I believe that that verse is important in realizing that all the trials and difficult situations we go through have a purpose. That God knows what we can handle and what we need much sooner than we can even comprehend the situation. And with having a senior year that was nothing like the movies, it's important to remember that God has a plan and a lesson for every second of our lives. We just need to pay attention to his calling.
Hi everyone, my name is Sydney Gordon and I'm the Director of Youth Formation and Youth Ministry at Church of St. Michael here in Farmington. From all of us at Church of St. Michael, we wanted to wish you congratulations to the class of 2021. Dear class of 2021, you experienced high school years like none other. You experienced trials, joys, deep sorrows, and hopefully moments of excitement and triumph. We're here to celebrate those moments with you. We're praying for you as you begin your next journey, and we wish you the best of luck in the next phase of your life. Remember to keep God close and that he's always with you as you continue to go about your new phase of life. Congratulations to class of 2021.
Hello, graduates and families of 2021. I am Jennifer Schneider from Church of St. Michael. And I first want to congratulate you and wish you good luck as you go on your new journey.
Good morning. I'm Scott Evenson from Faith United Methodist Church here in Farmington. I am a chaplain and an assistant at that congregation. One of my primary duties is feeding a lot of people. We run a loaves and fishes program that feeds about 250 people a week. So some of you may know me from that ministry. I just wanted to share with you a little bit. If any of you are like me, when you reach this time in your life, you've got a clear idea of what you want to do next on your journey. When I graduated, knew that I wanted to go into food service in some way, and I trained as a chef and hotel restaurant manager and spent about 20-some years of my life in that occupation. But as we've all experienced in this last year, life has a strange way of throwing wrenches into our ideas. In 1993, I was involved in an accident that left me mostly blind. So I have very limited vision and had to leave my career in hotel restaurant management and look for a new path to follow. And it made me think a lot about where we are, how we approach life, how we hold on to our ideas of what we want to accomplish in our lives, and how we need to sometimes relax that hold on our own ideas and allow God to work in our lives in His way. This is a piece by a French Jesuit priest, Pierre Teilhard de Chardin, and it's one of my favorite pieces, and something that I go back to all the time and remind myself. It's about patient trust. Above all, trust in the slow work of God. We are quite naturally impatient in everything to reach the end without delay. We should like to skip the intermediate stages. We are impatient of being on the way to something unknown, something new. And yet it is the law of all progress that it is made by passing through some stages of instability, and that it may take a very long time. And so I think it is with you. Your ideas mature gradually. Let them grow. Let them shape themselves without undue haste. Don't try to force them on as though you could be today what time will make of you tomorrow. Only God could say what this new spirit gradually forming within you will be. Give our Lord the benefit of believing that His hand is leading you, and accept the anxiety of feeling yourself in suspense and incomplete. Good luck on your journeys ahead, and please be patient and trust in God's hand in your life.
Hello, class of 2021. I'm Christine Clemens from Farmington Lutheran Church. Congratulations on this momentous milestone. We as a community are so proud of you and so excited to see all the amazing things that you do in the future. I'm going to read a passage from Philippians chapter 1 as to our hopes and our prayers for each of you. I thank my God every time I remember you, constantly praying with joy in every one of my prayers for all of you. Because of your sharing in the gospel from the first day until now, I am confident of this, that the one who began a good work in you will bring it to completion by the day of Jesus Christ. It is right for me to think this way about all of you because you hold me in your heart and for all you share in God's grace with me, both in my imprisonment and in the defense and confirmation of the gospel. For God is my witness, how I long for all of you with the compassion of Christ Jesus. And this is my prayer, that your love may overflow more and more with knowledge and full insight to help you determine what is best, so that in the day of Christ you may be pure and blameless, having produced the harvest of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ for the glory and praise of God. So congratulations, class of 2021. May you always be reminded of God's incredible love for you, His unconditional grace and forgiveness, and that through Him you can do all things. Congratulations.
Hello, my name is Josh. I serve at Connect Church in downtown Farmington. And congratulations, you have made it to graduation. The last year and a half have posed significant challenges for you, but you're here. Well done. Some of you are sad to leave high school behind. Some of you can't move on quick enough. Others are somewhere in between. Some of you are excited. Some of you are a bit frightened. What next? This is a new season of life for you, and I encourage you to embrace it. As I've grown older, I've seen far too many people attempt to recapture the glory of days gone by, whenever that time might have been. Sometimes, or oftentimes, it's an attempt to relive high school. Such an endeavor always amounts to foolishness. A very wise man, Kohelet, or the teacher, whose wisdom is encapsulated in in Ecclesiastes, in what we call the Old Testament, says that a fool chases after former days. There is no wisdom or peace there. Instead, the wise move forward in life, pursuing the light in that which is good, right, and true. And I encourage you on this day of graduation to do just that. Move forward in the path that is wise, fitting, and pleasing to God. And hey, I'm a Christian, I'm a pastor, so I think endeavoring or attempting to please God is a worthwhile thing to do. We all want to change the world. We all want to do something great. We want to make a difference, and most of the time, that difference is in the most mundane of things. It is serving others when no one sees. It is doing the little things that often go unlooked and unnoticed that will make you into the person that you want to be, that God wants you to be, and that truly makes a difference in this world and in the lives of others. Making a difference in this world, making a change, begins with making a difference in the life of the person sitting right next to you. This high school, Farmington, your teachers, your counselors, your administrators, parents, guardians, and others have prepared you for this next season of life. Be bold and courageous as you begin this new endeavor, wherever that may lead. Whatever you are feeling in this moment, find comfort in God who leads and guides your path into the future. Many blessings. May you find this next season of life full of wonder, full of grace, and full of peace, all rooted in Jesus Christ our Lord. Blessings to you.
Greetings, class of 2021. My name is Father Nick Fraley, and I'm a pastor of Church of St. Michael here in Farmington. And over the course of your time here in high school, I'm sure you've surmounted many challenges, but perhaps none so as great as what you've faced over the last year and a half. So congratulations on making it through your years of high school, and congratulations on making it to this great point where you're about to jump off into the next adventure. Recently, we celebrated the Feast of Pentecost when the Holy Spirit was poured out into the early church. And right before then, the apostles had gathered together in a place for prayer. They were ready and waiting to be sent out. And when the Holy Spirit came upon them, they were driven out and went to all the different corners of the known world, some as far as India, others to parts of Europe, and throughout the Middle East. And it's because of their reliance on the Holy Spirit that they had the courage to go where the Lord wanted them to. And they had the courage to preach good news and to stay true to what is good, beautiful, and just. And so this is my encouragement to you, that as you go forward from this place, you remain rooted in your prayer, that you turn to our loving God, and that you ask for an outpouring of the Holy Spirit, because now the Lord is sending you out. He's sending you out onto this next adventure. And there will be more challenges to face, but more adventures to be had. And so know of our prayers will go with you as you continue on in this journey of life. God bless you all, and congratulations on your graduation.
Congratulations, graduates. This is Pastor Kevin from Farmington Lutheran Church, and we are excited to celebrate this milestone with you. Graduates, I must tell you, and some of you I have had the pleasure of knowing really well, many of you I've known for more as of a distance, but I'm proud of who you are. And not just proud of your accomplishments, and there's been many championship teams, awesome talents with the arts, with drama, you as hockey players, runners, basketball players, and the list goes on and on and on. That in itself is impressive. But what I'm more excited about is who you are as people. As people of God, how you connect your faith with how you treat folks. How you want to make sure that life is good for your classmates, for your neighbors, folks who are like you and folks who aren't like you at all. That's an awesome thing. I see that as you look out for and you encourage younger teammates and those a few grades behind you. Please know how you treat people. Man, it's an awesome thing, and it's more important and more valuable than I think any of us understand. A word I want to share with you, as I'm excited to look at your future, is the word hesed. It's a Hebrew word that doesn't translate easily into English because it means God's faithfulness, God's generosity, God's kindness, God's goodness. And it's a story from the book of Ruth and other places where God's faithfulness, generosity, goodness, kindness shows up through ordinary people like you. You've learned all too well that there's so many things in life that are beyond our control. What other people do, what the powers that be, how they operate, things like global pandemics that cut short seasons and disrupt our plans. But we learn the story of Ruth, and we learn what hesed is. Hesed is how God's love and generosity shows up through ordinary people like you. In the story of Ruth, that generosity that showed up through folks like Ruth and Boaz and Naomi would end up being the factor that brought King David into being and shows also, or excuse me, also brought in the genealogy that had our Lord Jesus being born. And the whole message of that story is saying this: there's a lot of things in this life that we can't control, but you want to really change the world. You want to move the world. You know how you do it? You do it in the ordinary. Whether it's when you're a part of a team or an effort or anything, is showing God's generosity, God's kindness, God's faithfulness, God's goodness. I'm so proud of the ways that you have and continue to live that out. And I'm excited for this future. Why? Because in you and how you show God's hesed, that's going to move the world. Graduates, we love you. God loves you. We're proud of you. And blessings to you as you celebrate your graduation.
Friends, my name is Jamie Thompson. I serve as pastor at Lord of Life Lutheran Church, and again, I am so humbled and privileged to be here with you for this blessed occasion. God's grace and peace, and congratulations to one and all. At times, I often find it best to go to those that have far better words than I have. So here are a few that have spoken to me through the years that I just share with you. One is simply the title of a book. Book that I don't have with me today, I'm sorry, but it's simply the book titled Grit to Great. Grit focuses on the concept of guts or courage, resilience, initiative, and tenacity. Grit is not about sweat, not about swagger, far more about character. And so find your own sense of grit. Mother Teresa once said, if you judge people, you have no time to love them. William Butler Yeats said, education is not the filling of a pail, but the lighting of a fire. Aesop said, no act of kindness, no matter how small, is ever wasted. Charles Dickens is quoted as saying, no one is useless in the world who lightens the burden of it for anyone else. Helen Keller, although the world is full of suffering, it is also full of the overcoming of it. Albert Einstein, imagination is more important than knowledge. The important thing is not to stop questioning. Mark Twain, kindness is a language which the deaf can hear and the blind can see. The great apostle Paul in Philippians 1, I am confident of this, the one who began a good work in you will bring it to completion in the day of Jesus Christ. Paul also says in Philippians 4, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ makes it very clear. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, all your mind, and all your strength, and your neighbor as yourself. And Jesus again makes clear for us, my grace is sufficient for you. Friends, I have a brief story to share with you, and though I always put such a story into context, I need to make it clear to you that this story was told to me, so if you ever try it, you are on your own. Don't say to your professor or teacher that some pastor at my baccalaureate said I could do this. College student taking a final exam in philosophy was given 2 hours to write an essay answer to the question, prove or disprove the existence of God. The student's classmates began to write feverishly. This student simply wrote, it is impossible for an inferior being to prove or disprove the existence of a superior being. As the story was told to me, the student took all of 5 minutes, wrote this answer, turned it in, and walked out to the amazement of their fellow students, and the student received an A. Friends, this pandemic that you've experienced your junior and senior years has put events and time into context, and that is all. Experiences like this are obstacles, challenges, mistakes, missed opportunities, those unforeseeables that come our way, events out of our control. None of this defines us. These are stories on pages in different chapters in a really, really long book. And that book is you and who God created you to be. And you are his main character. You are the class of 2021, the class that has been resilient, strong, persevered, adjusted, no matter how you may have been impacted. You are the Farmington class of 2021, and you have stories to tell and new chapters that will unfold, and no one can take that from you. As fellow believers in our Savior Jesus Christ, you are the strongest of all. Faith is a funny thing. Those that don't have it will often ask us who have it. With everything going on in the world, how can you possibly believe in God? We would boldly answer them, how can I not? Where would I be in this world, in my journey, without my God? Friends, it is never too late, and we are never too old to learn something new. Or maybe you might just need to create it. Not sure those in your English department would appreciate me introducing you to a new word that, to my knowledge, has yet to turn up in a dictionary or on a Google search. And yet I invite you, let's go looking not just for opportunities. Let us go seek and discover and create awe opportunities, true moments of awe. I have a personal saying, even more so as I age more and more. I am grateful my role models need not be older than me. So on behalf of the very kingdom of God, on behalf of my own faith journey, thank you for being my role model in the faith, for being my brother and sister in Christ. You, my friends, are the believers not just of tomorrow. You are the believers and the church of today. And because you are the church and believers of today, thanks be to God, the church and the believers of tomorrow are in really, really good hands. Congratulations to each of you, my friends, my brothers and sisters in the faith, and God's very best to you and the entire class of 2021.
Beloved in Christ, with Abraham and Sarah, Naomi and Ruth, Paul and Barnabas, we are all travelers, sojourners, situated in a given place, sometimes only for a season. Changes call us forth from one community to another, and from the familiar to the unknown.
To all the graduates, we invite you to trust anew. Christ goes before you when and where you go. Be bold and confident, for indeed the goodness and mercy of God will guide you in all your comings and goings. Forever believe in the one who forever believes in you. For the Holy Spirit gives each of you strength and direction when you are unsure.
As you go to a new place, a new community, a new home, we send you out in Christ's name.
To all the parents, these can be emotional times. In the joy of your daughter or son graduating, we give thanks as you rejoice and share your joy with one another. Where there may be any sorrow, we understand your sadness. Where there are moments of great anticipation, we lift up your hopes and prayers for your daughter or son.
To the class of 2021, and to one and all as people of faith, go now with God. Be not tempted to stay in the safety of known places. Move from where you are to where God points you.
Go now with God. Be not tempted to go only in your time when it suits you or when it feels sure, for now is God's time.
Go now with God.
Go now with God.
Go now with God.
Go now with God. Choose not to go alone.
Go now in faith. There is not wilderness so vast that God is not already there to show you the way.
Amen. Amen.
Class of 2021, your family and your friends and your loved ones, as you celebrate this time, we invite you to also continue to build on and to celebrate the relationships and friendships that you've shared throughout these years. And then to go now with God, to go now with faith, and to build on the relationship that you share with the one who is forever in relationship with you. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Best to you, class of 2021. God's best.